Welcome back to Viking Basketball with head coach Barret Peery. As the Vikings come home this week, they host Eastern Washington on Thursday night and Idaho on Saturday night right here at the Viking Pavilion. And coach, this is 1 week out of an entire month that you're on the road. You get to be home 1 week, and this is the week. So the Vikings need to make things happen this week, I would say.
Yeah, and we're excited to be home. I think we've been looking forward to it. It's been a tough first stretch for us as far as starting the league. The schedule was not real favorable as far as our travel is concerned. So we're excited to be home, simply put.
Okay, and the Vikings will be looking for a victory at home. Haven't won at home here in a while. They've had some struggles recently, and we can point to some offensive inconsistencies, maybe the biggest issues you've had lately. On the road last week, turnovers hurt you, and in a couple of games that you had chances to win.
Yeah, we had great chances to win. We turned the ball over at an incredible rate. And that was not like us at all. You know, when we had come off that Weber game where I think we had 11, we came off that Montana game where we had 12. Obviously, those were good games for us, win or lose. And then we go turn it over on the road like we did with, you know, teams that are solid defensively, but not high pressure, not people that are trying to turn you over. They're trying to be more solid. We just had mental mistakes. We weren't sharp and still had chances to win both games, which was ironic because of how much we turned the ball over. It was incredible.
Okay, and as everybody's now home, they're sleeping in their own beds, they're getting comfortable. You got a few days to bounce back from that. So what are the adjustments you make in practice week as you get ready for Eastern on Thursday?
Well, obviously we talked about it and addressed it and looked at it on film, and you know, the guys acknowledged that way before I did, that they were sloppy and can do a better job with the ball. And so, you know, I think that we've looked it right in the eye, and I think we're excited to be home, get back in our own beds, like you said. And you know, home games guarantee nothing. We've proven that. We've played better sometimes on the road than at home. And so we need to come home, protect home court, get on a little run, and get some momentum for ourselves.
And probably one of the things the Vikings can look to is if they can improve some outside shooting. And they got a couple of guys. Deontay Strickland is coming on, has been playing pretty well lately. Mike Mayhew has gotten back into the starting lineup. He's a guy that we know can shoot the three. Those two guys perhaps start shooting it well from outside. That's probably going to help your offensive approach.
Yeah, fun to see both those guys kind of catch their stride and get going a little bit, getting their rhythm, Mike and Strick. And it's been coming. You know, you could see them, you know, getting better in practice and getting more comfortable, and they were doing a good job. Nuga didn't shoot the ball extremely well last week. You know, Boo Boo had a hard weekend too. And so for us, we just got to put things back together and get playing the way we can, the way we know, and do our jobs.
Okay, now we've talked about a few things, a few challenges the Vikings have had, but maybe enlighten us a few of the things that you like that you're seeing out of this group. Obviously, we knew going into the season a lot of new guys coming in, and you know, learning the system, those types of things. But what are you seeing that's pleasing you at this point?
Well, I think our team has made tremendous efforts, and I think our team is continuing to grow. Sometimes you don't get to see it in the win-loss column, but you know, you brought up that new guy thing. We have a lot of new guys, and so I really feel like we'll take a turn and catch our stride this week and then moving forward. I think a lot of guys are getting more and more comfortable. I think you've seen guys like Robert McCoy really get better and better. Sal's doing a good job. And they're starting to gel. They're playing better together, and I expect big things from them this week.
Okay, and as we talk about newness, the two opponents this week, Eastern Washington and Idaho, a couple of teams with extremely different looks from what they had last year. Eastern Washington loses the player of the year, Bogdan Bliznuk, who graduates. Idaho loses virtually its entire starting lineup, a number of seniors on that team. So, coach, you're looking at a couple of teams that have changed from last year.
Yeah, I think all three teams are learning each other's names, and as they learn about each other, learning each other's names. So, yeah, I think you'll see a new look group for sure. Eastern Washington, you know, just losing Bliznuk alone kind of changed their identity. They still shoot the ball very well from three and try to spread the floor and drive it and pitch it and get the ball shot from behind the arc and try to get three more than two. But, you know, Idaho has a new look as well, and they're battling and doing a good job.
Does that require the coaching staff to look at a little extra film because you're looking at a lot of new guys that you are in primary roles that maybe you haven't seen before with those teams?
No doubt. Yeah, no doubt. I think that immediately when you start looking at these teams with all the new personnel, that's exactly what's coming up. It's like, where'd he come from? Where's he from? Who is he? You know, all those kind of things. And so, yeah, we're learning just like everybody else.
Okay, and now the keys to Portland State getting a couple wins at home this week.
You know, we have to play confident at home. We haven't been a confident team last week. We were kind of passive and tentative with the ball, which led to turnovers. I didn't think we were dumb with the ball. I thought we were kind of not confident enough. We need to come home and play confident, play aggressive, be comfortable on our home court, but also realize nothing is given and we're going to have to battle.
All right, there it is. The Vikings at home this week in the Viking Pavilion. Thursday night, Eastern Washington. Saturday, Idaho. Both games tipping off at 7:05 p.m. If for all the information on Viking basketball, go to govikes.com.